Today I am discussing about classification of nuclear power plant, that means various types of nuclear reactors used in nuclear power plant. Actually it is classified based on 5 parameter: basis of neutron energy and basis of fuel used, based on moderator used, and the coolant used. The last one is type of core using. Generally in the nuclear power plant, various types of nuclear reactors used classified into 5 types. In that, the first one, the basis of neutron energy, based on neutron energy. Here there are 2 types of the reactors used in the neutron energy. One is for the thermal reactor, another one is for the fast reactor. Thermal reactor, another one is for the fast reactor. In the thermal reactor, the moderator is used, but in the fast reactor, moderator is not used. Actually in the nuclear power plant, once the fission process is taken place, that is with the fuel used is uranium, thorium or plutonium, once the fission process is appeared, it releases for the radioactive substances. Generally in that we are using for the moderator, it absorbs some amount of the radioactive substances. If you are not used for the moderator, directly it releases for the fast neutron. In that, the radioactive substances is entering into the atmospheric particle. But maximum in the nuclear power plant, they are preferred for the thermal reactors. They are preferred for thermal reactors. The second one, it is preferred on the basis of fuel used. In the nuclear power plant, the fuel we are using is uranium, thorium, and then plutonium. Uranium, thorium, and then plutonium. But maximum they are preferred for the uranium, another one is for the plutonium. Again in uranium, it is classified for 2 types of fuel. One is for the natural uranium, another one is for the enriched uranium. Natural uranium, the number is represented for 238, and the enriched uranium, that is 235, and the plutonium is 239. But maximum in the nuclear power plant, they are preferred for the enriched uranium, that is uranium 235. Actually in the enriched uranium, the efficiency we are getting is maximum, and another one, the fuel utilization, that is the consumption, is also somewhat less, because here the wastage particle is very very less. Once we are using for fuel, we are getting more than 85% of the efficiency comparing to the natural uranium and the plutonium. The maximum, all the nuclear power plant, they are preferred for the enriched uranium. Enriched uranium. And the next classification based upon the moderator used. Moderator used. Actually here the moderator, the particulars they are used is graphite reactor, heavy water reactor, ordinary reactor, beryllium reactor, and last one is organic reactor. In the nuclear power plant, they are preferred only for the graphite reactor. In that, the graphite material, it is not released for the open atmospheric, that is this radiation particle, that is the radioactive substances. If in the reactor core is any alpha particle or beta or gamma radiation released, means this graphite particle absorbed and it is not reflected into the open atmosphere. It is not fed back into the open environment. Generally the moderator, the material they are used for the graphite reactor, that is they are preferred for the material is graphite material in the nuclear power plants. And the next classification is on the basis of coolant. On the basis of coolant, this is used in the moderator. There are ordinary water cooled reactor, heavy water cooled reactor, gas cooled reactor, liquid metal cooled, another one is for the organic liquid cooled reactor. Actually in the nuclear power plant, the initial or capital cost is very very high and the fuel cost is maximum. Fuel cost is maximum. For coolant purpose, if you go for the gas cooled reactor or organic liquid or liquid metallic cooled, again the cost is increased. At present, the per unit cost we are generating in the nuclear power plant, it is more or less around 20 rupees. Same we are compared in the renewable energy sources, that is solar power plant, the per unit cost is considered only 4 rupees. If the same power we are generating in the thermal power plant, the per unit cost is considered for either 3 to 5 rupees. 3 to 5 rupees. But here the per unit cost is high Actually, the main objective of the power system is we need to satisfy for the consumer two parameters. One is for the quality, another one is for the quantity. Quality means without interruption and without load fluctuation. Quantity means at reasonable price. At reasonable price. Here, the cooling purpose if used for the gas-cooled reactor means again the burden is presented for the consumer. Again, the cost is increased. Again, the per unit cost is increased 21 rupees or 22 rupees. The consumers are not satisfied. For that purpose, the coolant in the nuclear power plant, they are preferred for the ordinary water-cooled reactor. Ordinary water-cooled reactor. And the last one, on the basis of type of core used, Here, there are two types of core is there. One is nothing but the homogeneous reactor. Another one is for the heterogeneous reactor. Here, the type of core is classified for two types. One is for the homogeneous reactor. Another one is for the heterogeneous reactor. But maximum, in the nuclear power plant, they are preferred for the homogeneous reaction, homogeneous reactors. These are the various classification of the nuclear reactors in the nuclear power plants. Next topic is the nuclear reactor. It is classified for three types. One is for the boiling water reactor. It is represented for BWR. The second one, pressurized water reactor, that is PWR. And next one is nothing but the fast breeder reactor, that is represented for FBR. Generally, in the nuclear power plant, the nuclear reactors are classified into three types. One is for boiling water reactor, that is represented for BWR. Pressurized water reactor is represented for PWR. The another one, fast breeder reactor is represented for FBR. But in the nuclear power plant, they are preferred for the pressurized water reactor, PWR. Why they are preferred pressurized water reactor? This we can go through it. In that, the first one is the boiling water reactor. This is one of the simplest type of water reactor. Here the fuel used is enriched uranium. Here in the boiling water reactor, the fuel used is enriched uranium. That is the enriched uranium. It is represented for uranium 235. Uranium 235. Here, it is used for both, that is the moderator and the coolant purpose. This boiling water reactor, water is used both moderator and coolant. In this case, the steam is generated in the reactor itself. Here, they are not used for the moderator. Only they are used only for the reactor. In this reactor itself, the steam is generated. That is the fed water, that is, the water is carried from the fed water pump. The water is carried from the fed water pump, entering into the reactor tank at the bottom. That is the bottom, the water it will be entering. And the heat generated due to the fission process. The heat generated due to the fission process based upon the control rod. Whenever the control rod is pushed towards the fuel, some amount of the fission is observed. That is only few neutrons are released. Whenever the control rod is pulled out, that is pulled upward, more number of fission is released. The power generation is maximum. Based upon the demand, you can control the power generation based upon the control rod. Here, the steam is generated during the fission process and converted into steam. That steam leaves the reactor at the top. The bottom, we are supplying the fed water, and the top we have taken for the steam. This steam drives the steam turbine, which converts the steam energy into mechanical energy. Further, that mechanical energy convert into electric energy with the help of alternator. Again, the wastage steam collected in the condenser again circulated to the reactor in the form of fed water. And here, the water and then the steam, the both it will be merged to each other. Here, they are not used for the moderator. Here, one main drawback is that directly it releases the steam in the reactor itself. That drives the steam turbine. If any radioactive substances are entered, it enters into the environment, it polluted to the environment. And one more drawback, it cannot meet sudden increasing in load. Suppose now the demand is 320 megawatt. Suddenly now the demand is increased to 470 megawatt. That is the 150 megawatt, the demand is increased within a short interval of time. Within short interval of time, the demand is not fulfilled by using the boiling water reactor. Why it is not fulfilled means here they are not used for the heat exchanger, that is the moderator we are not using, directly drives the steam turbine. That is the water as well as steam is only taken place in the single place, that is in the reactor itself. Due to that, the efficiency is also very, very less. The advantages in that the boiling water reactor is, this reactor does not require heat exchanger circuit separately. Due to that, the cost is minimized. This is the advantage. And the thermal efficiency of the reactor plant is considerably higher than the pressurized water reactor. And the major drawback in that the boiling water reactor is, in this the BWR cannot meet sudden increasing in load. Suddenly if the demand is increased, we can't satisfy it for the demand within short interval of time, that is within a minute. And here the radioactive contaminant, the steam is released in the director. If any alpha or beta or gamma radiation is released, means that directly drives the steam turbine. The wastage, maximum amount of the steam is wastage in the turbine. Here it collected in the condenser, there it enter into the atmospheric particle. Due to that, the living, both living as well as for the non-living organisms are affected. And these are the drawback of the boiling water reactor. Here they are not used for the heat exchanger. For that purpose, this is not preferred that much. Due to that, it polluted to the environment due to the radioactive substances. And the second one is the pressurized water reactor. It is represented for the PWR. Pressurized water reactor is represented for PWR. Here, the pressurized water reactor, it is nothing but a thermal reactor. The pressurized water reactor is nothing but thermal reactor. Maximum, all the nuclear power plant, they are preferred for the PWR, that is the pressurized water reactor. Here the fuel used is enriched uranium. In the pressurized water reactor, the fuel used is enriched uranium, that is uranium-235. Uranium-235 plus adding one small neutron, we are getting unstable uranium, that is uranium-236. Whenever the fission process is taken place, it is bombarded, and due to the nuclear fission, the splitting of heavy nuclei into two or more small nuclei, that is splitting into two small nuclei, that is for the lanthanum, another one is nothing but the bromine, and it releases for the three small neutrons, and releases for the three small neutrons. Due to that, the chain process is taken place. But here, the fuel used in the pressurized water reactor is, that is the enriched uranium, uranium-235. Here the water is used for both moderator as well as for the coolant. But here, this is nothing but the nuclear reactor, and the separate they are used for the heat exchanger. Here that used for the two parameter. The fed water is given into the heat exchanger. In the tube, whenever the fission process is taken place, the hot coolant is flowing into the tube, surrounding the water. This the water converted in the form of steam. Here the separate chamber is there. One is nothing but the water chamber, another one is nothing but the steam chamber. The generated steam, this is nothing but without the moisture particle. Directly the steam drives the steam turbine. It can convert the steam energy into mechanical energy. In this, the pressurized water reactor, within short interval of time, suddenly the demand is increased. We can fulfill the demand by using this, the pressurized water reactor. And the efficiency is also maximum. Suppose if any radioactive substance is released here, it is not directly mingled into the heat exchanger. In this, the reactor core itself observed in the shielding. And here, the pump circulated the water. Used is high, that is nothing but the pressure is nothing but 140 kg per centimeter square. That is the water is circulated in the nuclear power plant. The pressure is 140 kg per centimeter square. And liquid state, the temperature is 240 degrees centigrade. here in this the heat exchanger, the temperature is maintained from 240 degree centigrade. But in the nuclear power plant, temperature is maintained from 250 degree centigrade to 500 degree centigrade. The temperature is maintained from 250 degree centigrade to 500 degree centigrade. But in the fed water, the temperature is maintained from 240 degree centigrade. Here in the pressurized water reactor, the advantage is the reactor is compact in size comparing to the boiler water reactor. And the water is used for coolant purpose, moderator. And the cost is very, very less comparing to the boiler water reactor as well as for the fast breeder reactor. And here the load is increased in the pressurized water reactor, supplied is more power. Suppose the suddenly demand is increased, suddenly the demand is increased. Within a minute, we can satisfy it for the demand. But these features, it is not available in the boiler water reactor. But maximum, all the nuclear power plants, they are preferred for the pressurized water reactor. And the drawback is occurrence of heat losses in the heat exchanger. Again, in this, the heat exchanger, due to 10 to 15% of the steam is wasted. That is the major drawback. And thermal efficiency of the pressurized water reactor is low. That is 20% maximum, 15 to 20% of the steam is wasted. Due to that, the thermal efficiency is minimized. Thermal efficiency is minimized. And one more thing, the safety precautions, it should be taken comparing to the other type of reactors. Other type of reactors. The next one is fast breeder reactor. In the name itself available, there is nothing but the fast breeder reactor. Here, the power generation is maximum. In the name itself mentioned, there is that type is nothing but the fast breeder reactor. Here, in the fast breeder reactor, they are not used for the moderator. They are not used for the heat exchanger. Only they are used for the reactor core. Once they are generated the steam, that directly drives the steam turbine. But in the previous cases, they are used for the water. But here, they are used for the NA, that is nothing but the sodium. Here, they are preferred for the material. That is, they are used for enriched uranium, that is uranium-235. They are used for uranium-235. Once the fission process is taken place in the control rod, whenever the control rod is pushed into the fission, pushed into the core, observe the some amount of the fission process, it releases for a small amount of neutrons. Due to that, the power generation is minimum. Whenever the control rod is pulled out, more number of the fission process is releases. Due to that, the power generation is maximum. The power generation is maximum. And one more thing, here they are not used for the moderator and then heat exchanger. We can't control for the fission process. Here, the power generation is maximum. More number of the fission process is released. More number of the fission process is released. We can't control the power generation. We can't control the power generation. Due to that, here the drawback is huge amount of the fuel is required. The fuel consumption is maximum. Here already we know that in the nuclear power plant, the fuel cost is very, very high. The fuel cost is very, very high comparing to the remaining other conventional power plant. The fuel utilization is maximum in the fast breeder reactor. And another one, it is not observed for the moderator as well as for the heat exchanger. Due to that, directly the radioactive substances entering into the turbine, entering into the atmosphere, due to that, it polluted to the environment. It polluted to the environment. For that purpose, the fast breeder reactor, they are not preferred that much of thing. Comparing to these three, boiler water reactor, pressurized water reactor, another one is for the fast breeder reactor, they are preferred only for the pressurized water reactor. They are preferred only for the pressurized water reactor. And the differences between the nuclear fission and the nuclear fission. There are two processes taken place. One is nothing but the fission process, another one is for the fusion process. Already this last class we have discussed, the nuclear, the fission means the splitting of heavy nuclei into two or more small nuclei is nothing but the nuclear fission. That is the example here we are taken for uranium-235. Uranium-235. 235. We are adding one small neutron. We are adding one small neutron. We are getting the unstable uranium 236. That is, this is nothing but the heavy nuclei. The splitting of heavy nuclei into two or more small nuclei is nothing but nuclear fission. That is, it releases splitting of two small nuclei. One is nothing but the lanthanum. Another one is for the bromine, and it releases for the three small neutrons. It releases for three small neutrons. Nothing but the nuclear fission means the splitting of heavy nuclei into two or more. The small nuclei is nothing but the nuclear fission. But in the nuclear fusion means lower and then higher mass energy. It is gathered into the central particle. The finally it releases for the single nuclei. Single nuclei. Here the example we are taken for the two hydrogen element, that is the lower as well as for the higher the mass value, bring into the center particle, the finally it releases for the helium. This is called as the nuclear fusion. And in the nuclear the fission process, the result is the emission of the radioactive rays. Process of resulting the emission of the radioactive rays. But in the fusion process, it does not emit any radioactive rays. It does not emit any radioactive substances. Radioactive rays, in the sense, it releases for the alpha rays, beta rays, another one is for the gamma rays. Generally, in the alpha radiation means, it is, in this alpha radiation, it is not affected for the human being. It is taken place in the reactor itself. It is not entered into the open atmosphere. Due to that, the effect is very, very less. But due to the beta and then gamma radiation, it is affected for the whole living as well as for the non-living organism, enter into the open atmosphere. Due to the beta rays, the human being affected for the cancer. A number of cancers are appeared. And due to the gamma radiation, DNA problem, the inspiration problem, skin diseases are appeared. In this, the fission process, the emission of the radioactive rays. But in the fusion process, it is not emitted any kind of radioactive rays. And in this, the nuclear fission, it is operated under ordinary temperature. Under normal temperature, the process is taken place. But in the fusion process, the heavy temperature is required. In fusion process, heavy temperature is required. And in the nuclear fission, chain reaction is taken place. And in the nuclear fission, it does not produce any chain reaction. The chain reaction means it is bombarded, that is the splitting of heavy nuclei into two or more small nuclei. Here three neutron is formed. Again we are adding one more small neutron. Again the chain reaction, again 3 plus 3 into 3, again 9 neutrons are released. Again it is bombarded, 27 neutrons are released. That is, chain process is taken place in the fission process, and it does not produce any chain reaction in the nuclear fission. During nuclear fission, neutrons are emitted, but in the nuclear fusion, positrons are emitted. And in the nuclear fission, it can be performed under controlled condition. But in the nuclear fusion, we can perform it under, it is not, cannot be performed under uncontrolled condition. This is the differences between nuclear fission and the nuclear fusion. So simply, the nuclear fission means splitting of heavy nuclei into two or more the small nuclei is nothing but the nuclear fission. The best example is this operation under 35 conditions. This the nuclear fission can be performed under 35 conditions. Here I am given the example, the only one condition, that is the uranium 235. We are adding one small neutron. We are getting one unstable uranium 236. Once it is bombarded, that is fission process is taken place. It releases for the two small nuclei. One is nothing but the lanthanum, another one is for the bromine, and it releases for the three small neutrons. And nuclear fusion means, that is the lower as well as for the higher the mass value, bring into the center particle, the final we are getting for single nuclei. That is two hydrogen element, the output we are getting in the form of helium. The next, the differences between fissile and then fertile material. That is, the fissile material is undergoes in the nuclear fission process. The splitting of heavy nuclei into two or more the small nuclei. That is, whenever the bombarded in the fission process, that is uranium-235. Uranium-235. We are adding one small neutron, that is unstable uranium-236. Once the bombarded, the fission process is getting. We are getting two small nuclei. One is nothing but the lanthanum. Another one is for the bromine. Another one is for the bromine. But in the fertile material, it's captured a neutron and converted that into a fissile material. That converted into a this the fissile particle. And the fissile material is a fissionable material. That is nothing but the burning process. But the fertile material is non-fissionable material. That is non-burning material. This converted into the fissile material. And in the fissile material, one neutron is sufficient to form a chain reaction. One neutron is sufficient to form a chain reaction. But in the fertile material, more number of neutrons is required to convert the fertile to fissile material. Fertile to fissile material. That is here, we are using uranium-235. We are only adding for the one small neutron. We are getting for the fissile process is taken place. But here, the fertile into the fissile material, we are getting more number of neutrons. That is the fissile material is represent for uranium-233 and plutonium-239. The fertile material means uranium-234, uranium-238 and then thorium-232. Actually, in the nuclear power plant, the major drawback is it releases for the radioactive substances. Due to that, it polluted to the environment for both living as well as for the non-living organism. How we can control the radioactive material? What are the measures we can take to control the radioactivity? The main thing in that the entire power plant designed with high degree of inherent safety. High degree of inherent safety. It is this parameter taken at the time of construction itself. And the entire plant is properly shielded against radiation hazards. Radiation hazards. That is the alarm signal is taken place. If any either alpha rays or beta or gamma rays, it releases in the nuclear reactor, automatically shielded in the power plant itself. That is, the nuclear power plant, the construction is the rugged construction and closed type. And one more thing, all the nuclear power plant is constructed away from the populated area. And the reactor should enclose thick concrete casing. The material in the concrete casing, the material they are used for, the graphite material. These are the various measures they are considered to avoid the radioactive substances. And the person working in the power plant, everyone having for the radiation meter, always they need to observe the radiation level. Suppose if the radiation is increased, means automatically they are shut down for the power plant. They are shut down for the power plant. Automatically is there, another one is for the manual is there. And based on the always they are measured for the radiation meter. And one more thing in the nuclear power plant, they are working for all are for well-educated person and well-trained person. Well-trained person. And the entire power plant is automatic operation from reactor to up to the end of the alternator. From all the equipment is operated for the automatic operation. Suddenly, if the temperature is increased or any radioactive substance is entered, automatically the measured in the radiation level, automatically the plant is also shut off. Like that, we are designed for the nuclear power plant. And the major drawback is the radioactive substances can be collected in a deep trench. That is, the wastage particle is collected, that is sent into the deep trench. Every twice a year, we are shut down for the power plant, 30 to 60 days, that is 1 to 2 months. At that time, we are removing these radioactive substances and send it away from the populated area, away from the environment. And the major thing, suppose if any accident is taken place, the effect is maximum and the losses is also more. For that purpose, it is prohibited to build. That is, the power plant can be constructed away from the residential building, away from school, colleges, and somewhat nearby the load center. And proper precaution against toxic and then radiation hazards. And we need to measure for the nameplate details. Some of the time, the industrial visit persons are coming, the auditing is going on. You need to mention all the parameter in the display boards. These are the various measures taken in the to control radioactive substances. And main control of the nuclear power plant, there are two controllers there. One is nothing but with the help of control rod, another one flow of the coolant. actually in that the whole power plant, the nuclear power plant can control based upon the controller. This represent for the K factor. It represent for the K factor that is defined as the ratio of number of neutrons produced in any one generation by number of neutrons produced in the presiding generator. Actually, if you go for take for any of the power plant, they are not run for the single generator. They go for the parallel operation, either two generation system or four or eight generation system. That is, in single generation, how much the neutrons is produced divided by the whole number of neutrons produced in the presiding generator. That is all generated. Under normal operating condition, that is the K factor, the value is unity. The value is unity. Whenever the control rod is pushed towards the core, it observes the fission process. Small amount of the neutron is released. That is, the K value is less than unity. Whenever the control rod is pulled out, n number of neutrons are released. At that time, the K value is more than unity. Suppose if the K value is very, very low, if the K value is too low, automatically the plant is shut off. Based upon the control rod only, we are operating for the nuclear power plant. And the second one, control through flow of coolant. Well, at constant temperature, the power output is proportional to the rate of flow of coolant. In the nuclear power plant, these are the two main control. We are controlling the nuclear power plant with the help of the control rod. Another one is for the control through flow of coolant. And the maintenance of the nuclear power plant, generally in the nuclear power plant, every 2 years, one, the plant shut down for the outage purpose. That is, under operating condition, we can't any the maintenance taken place in the nuclear power plant. Every twice a year, we are shut downing for the nuclear power plant. At that time, remove from the radioactive substances. At that time, that is, the plant is shut down for 30 to 60 days. And we need to go for the any alternative power generation, that is a thermal power plant or hydro power plant. Maximum these outages, they are kept for the rainy season. The water available more, they are remaining that the power demand satisfied the consumer with the help of the hydroelectric power plant. At the time they are shut down. And the outages means what are the activity they are taken place means under during running condition we can't perform this thing. Refueling the reactor and other preparations, external preventive maintenance like turbine and then generator, because this is rotating part. Every yearly or twice a year, the turbine and then alternator maintenance is required, and modifications or replacement of the any major equipment. These are the various maintenance taken place in the nuclear power plant.